Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about types of cloud computing and cloud computing services. If you're new to this channel, and to give you overview of what this series of videos is all about, it is named as Azure for Analytics because Azure is wide and we have different solutions can be implemented in it as it provides various services. So this series of videos predominantly focuses on how we can implement analytical solution, that is data and analytical solutions in Azure. That is the prime focus of this series of videos. If you are new to this channel and haven't subscribed this channel yet, do it right now and press the bell icon for notification. With this note, let's begin our today's topic. So types of cloud computing, we have already seen like what is the definition of cloud computing. Like it's like you do not own any hardwares or softwares for your development. Instead, you can purchase it or hire it, or you can use it as and when required, then you can release it, right? That is the concept behind the cloud computing. So what are different types available? First thing is like public clouds. As we said before, cloud environments typically created from IT infrastructure, not owned by the end user, right? So any infrastructure, I mean anything, right? Infrastructure or other things, it's not owned by anything, not owned by end users is the keyword here. When the cloud environments are partitioned and redistributed to multiple tenants, say for example, you have a one big server, right? The Microsoft owns it in the cloud, and for the client A or company A, some virtual machines are created in the server. For company B, in the same server itself, company B also utilizes the virtual machine, but there is no relation between the company A cannot log into company B credentials, I mean the servers. That is different story. They are not sharing the spaces, right? But within the same server, two company datas can be stored. That is the public cloud. In case of private clouds are loosely defined as cloud environments solely dedicated to a single end user or group. So in the same example, instead of a dedicated one server shared by different companies, one particular server is dedicated to one company alone. Nobody can or no other companies can store their data in that server. In that case, it becomes a private cloud. So private clouds are defined closely and even solely dedicated to single and user or group, right? Where the environment usually runs behind that user or group's firewall. So within that group's firewall also, they can configure it. Hybrid clouds, it's a combination of public and private, as the name indicates, bound together by technology that allows data and application to be shared between them. So some of the things may be private, some of the things may be public. So these combination becomes your hybrid cloud technologies. So these are different cloud computing types. And once you choose either we will go for public or private clouds, inside that most of the services are same. So what are different services available you can utilize in the clouds? That is your types of cloud services. So there are different services when we narrow down, but it is broadly categorized into three. The first one is infrastructure as a service. When you use the servers, virtual machines, storage, network, operating system, you use only the infrastructure, then it becomes a infrastructure as a service. So rent a IT infrastructure. Platform as a service. So you use only the platform like web and mobile apps, then it becomes the platform as a service. See, one sits on top of it, right? First, you need to have this infrastructure, then only you can build a web or mobile apps. So mostly interrelated things, right? So but you say like you use everything here and you build your own applications by yourself, then it becomes a platform as a service. That is like This platform as a service, which will supply on-demand environment for developing, testing, delivering and managing software application. You want to develop your software, instead of purchasing Visual Studio or any other software platforms, you use it in the Azure portal, right? For developing and testing and delivering, then it becomes a platform as a service. The third broad category comes as software as a service. Method of delivering software applications over the internet on demand and typically on a subscription basis. So this is typically one of the thing like Microsoft Office 365, where Microsoft owns everything. They have created the SMTP server and the IT infrastructure. They already developed all the products, right, in Office 365. It can be email, it can be Teams, most of the other products inside that. What you are doing, you just subscribe it, right? You 500 members in your organization, you approach Microsoft, they will create a Microsoft Office 365 account for 500 members. You are not owning anything infrastructure, you didn't build that software, right? So just you are utilizing that software. So software as a service, for that you will pay for it. Once you do not wish to continue it, then just you will leave it, right? Then you are not charged for virtual machines or nothing. As and when you use, how long you use, for that you will be charged. So these are different types of cloud services you can avail in the cloud computing environment. In case of Azure, these are the broad categories. So as you can see here, server, storage, networking, that as considered as IaaS, that is infrastructure as a service. Then development tools, operating systems, these are considered as a platform as a service. Then hosted applications, some applications are hosted in the cloud. Internally, obviously these services can be using any of this, right? So one is closely related to it. So this is the overall idea about different services you can avail in the cloud. Now let us try to see with some diagram, like the differentiation in visual manner. Like once it is again to make you to understand what is cloud computing, how it is different, what is IaaS PaaS, right? In this way, it is summarizes everything whatever we discussed till now. So when you own your own IT infrastructure, you are building your own software. You need to on-site means on-premise applications, data, runtime, middleware, OS, virtualization, servers, storage, network, everything you need to manage. But you think like, I want to go for infrastructure as a service. So what you manage is like, you build your application, you have your data, runtime, middleware, but virtualization, server, storage, networking, okay, these concepts can be managed by the service providers, that is Microsoft or Azure. When it comes to platform as a service, you give everything to the Azure or cloud providers. Only you will develop only the applications and you store the data. Okay, so this is how the platform as a service work. Then there comes the software as a service. So there will be already pre-built applications available in the cloud. Then you are utilizing it, or you build everything and some other people utilize it. Then it becomes a software as a service, right? So this is the concept behind it. Whenever any organization, we call it as SaaS startups, something like that, right? So they build everything on the cloud, or they build it on-premise, whatever it may be. So once they build it, as a customer, you are not going to do anything with that. You're just using that application or software, then becomes software as a service. So this is the concept behind IaaS, PaaS and SaaS. Now let's try to understand this cloud computing different types of services with the pizza as a service, right? We all know pizza. We are our favorite food is pizza. Let us try to understand it. So traditionally, if you want to make a pizza, if you want to eat pizza, assume there is no shops making pizza, you have to have, or you are owning everything. I mean, in order to make it, you need cheese, toppings, tomato sauce. You are making pizza dough, fire, oven, electric, gas, soda, dining table, everything. You are owning it and you are making it. You are enjoying your meal. So that is your made at home. Then this has become so much complex. I don't want to take a headache of making this tomato sauce topping and all. You thought like, let me buy it from someone or some get it from someone, right? So these pizza dough, tomato sauce and toppings and cheese, okay, these are the things you buy it outside, take and bake. Now these are the things you take, but still you use your own oven, electric gas, fire and soda and dining table. Still you need to make something, right? You need to prepare, you need to put it in a table, then arrange that tomato sauce, everything, then you put it in oven, right? Still you do the development. You cannot eat it until it's developed. So this is what infrastructure as a service, the raw materials in this case, and servers, virtual machines, and all other stuffs, right? That is called infrastructures. So those are this just a comparison, okay? Then it becomes infrastructure as a service. Now, you do not want to do anything. You buy everything here, pizza dough, tomato sauce, even making of it, right? Whatever, how it has been making, right? Making is our developing work. That is also you do not want to do, okay? Then this also you are using it from a vendor. Someone is doing for you. You are paying for it. Then just you are using your dining table and soda you brought. Then you are drinking it and I mean having your pizza. This is what your platform as a service. Finally, what happens? You decided, I do not want to make anything. Just I will go and buy pizza outside. Everything let them make. Okay. Just coming outside, you buy a pizza and eating at anywhere. I mean, the slight configuration, you still going to have it in your dining table or whatever. But I'm saying just you are not bothered about how the pizza is made. What is the thing? Your aim is to eat pizza. Just you are buying it from the pizza store, then you are having your pizza. This is this typical comparison between pizza and cloud technologies. I hope you understand the getting the point. What is cloud technology? How platform as service, infrastructure as service, software as a service differentiates, right? If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.